Okay, so today we're going to talk about how to set up the polymer plate maker so that we can create a polymer plate. First things first, we need to set up the equipment to make sure that it's at optimal temperature for the process. And we'll start by making sure that the empty water well is filled with lukewarm water. Continuing to fill this to the point where the water reaches the top of the bristles. And that way we have an appropriate amount of water. So as the polymer plate goes through the wash, it'll come in contact with the bristles and wash off any excess polymer. Make sure that the water temperature is about lukewarm, slightly warmer than room temperature. And to ensure that the water temperature is kept constant throughout the process, you're going to activate this heater button here. At the same time, as part of the prep, you should also turn on the heater, the blower motor, so that the drying area in here will come up to temperature. And give it a couple minutes, and we're ready to start. So now we're ready to prep our polymer plate material for exposure in the polymer machine, the Polimero machine. What I have here is an orthofilm that was produced at an output service bureau. And you can see with the orthofilm, this is what we're going to use to expose the polymer plate. We can see there's two sides to the orthofilm. This is a shiny side, and then there's a dull side. The dull side is the emulsion side. And this is the side that we want to put in contact with the polymer in order to expose that. So this diagram will show us how the polymer plate is constructed. There's a clear carrier below the polymer material, this being the polymer here. And what we want to do is have the orthofilm come in contact directly with the polymer. Similarly, the orthofilm has a clear carrier and the black orthographic material, which once exposed will have gaps within the black film that will allow light to go through. What we need to do is make sure that the black film is in contact directly on top of the polymer, because when we take a look at our light source, we want to make sure that the light is going through first the orthofilm plastic carrier and then shielded by the black orthofilm so that it only exposes certain areas of the polymer plate. If this orthofilm were turned upside down, the thickness of the carrier material, however small it may cause the light to bend and therefore giving you very soft edges on your final result in the polymer, and therefore not giving you a good quality polymer plate. So at this point we want to take the polymer plate material out of the black bag. This is light sensitive material, so turning off the lights beforehand, dimming the shades is a good practice. It's not light sensitive to the point where we have need to work in a dark room, but just work with dim light would be preferable. So what I'm going to do here, you can see the polymer plate material is this orange material. There's a carrier sheet, a plastic sheet underneath that holds the polymer, and then there's also a protective plastic coating on this sheet which will peel off, and you can see that here. So what we're going to do is try to be as efficient as possible with our material, and we're just going to cut this material to the size and shape of this orthofilm. So on the cutting mat, we're just going to mark where this should be cut, here, like this, and then put the film aside using your ruler. We're just going to line this up and try to do this in multiple passes so that you're not trying to cut through all of the material in one pass. Cork back steel rulers are ideal for this on a cutting mat, and a couple of passes will get you through the polymer and then the backing plastic as well. Same goes with this side. Couple of passes, And this piece should be ready to come off, like so. The rest of the polymer should go back into the black bag and back into the box to prevent it from being overexposed. All right. There we go. So now, in preparation for going to the exposing tray, what we want to do is find the corner of the material that covers the polymer, protects the polymer, and we're going to peel that off. Now what we've done is expose the polymer. The plastic backing is on the back side of this, and what we want to do is take our orthofilm using the emulsion side, which is the dull side, putting it in contact with the polymer and placing that in the exposing tray. So here we have our orthofilm on top of our polymer plate material, and we're ready to take that over to be exposed. As you can see with this orthofilm, we have a right reading orthofilm that will give us a right reading polymer plate. You'll see the result of that when it comes out, but unfortunately for our purposes on the letterpress, what we want is a wrong reading impression so that when it gets inked and the paper passes over and makes contact with the polymer plate, we will have a right reading impression on the paper. So that's something that the Output Service Bureau that creates your polymer, your orthofilm can help you with in getting it set up properly and ready for use in our system here. So moving over to the exposing tray. What we're going to do is lift off the plastic cream material and place the polymer plate down with the orthofilm on top. Bring the cream back down over top of all of that, and we're going to sandwich that together with the vacuum, turning on the vacuum pump down below here. We'll start to hear the vacuum motor working, and as we spread out the cream and work out all of the air bubbles, you'll see that we have a nice even contact around the polymer plate with the orthofilm in tight contact with that. So in order to expose it, we're going to slide the drawer in, and then we have a dial down here which we're going to turn to the right clockwise. That will turn the lights on. You can see here we have a UV light now exposing the polymer plate. But more importantly, what we want to do is measure off with maybe a watch with a second hand, 3.5 minutes. Unfortunately, this timer doesn't work very well. It's about 40 years old. And so we want to make sure that we have a proper exposure of 3.5 minutes for this particular orthofilm combination with polymer plate. And given the age and exposure of our lamps, that we have all these factors figured into 3.5 minute exposure. Okay, so we're just about done 3.5 minutes of exposing this. Now when it gets to 3.5 minutes, we're gonna have to turn off the exposing lamps by turning this dial back to zero. Like I said, this timer doesn't work properly, and that's why it's suggested you use a minute hand. And now we've turned it off. We can see the exposing lights, the UV lights have been turned off. And what we can also do is turn off the vacuum, which will allow us to remove the combination of orthofilm and polymer plate. We're done with the orthofilm now. We can put that aside. And I don't know whether or not you can see this, but you can see an impression on the polymer plate of what has been exposed. At this point, we've removed the orthofilm from this surface. The clear carrier on this polymer plate is on the back side, which is where we're going to attach it to the washing tray. We want to make sure that the it's not the polymer side that we attach to this green material, but the clear carrier. And what we're going to do now is place this in the water and turn on this timer for about 3 minutes as well. Okay, just have a look here. We're in about a minute in, and you can see that the polymer that hasn't been exposed, that was protected by the orthofilm, is starting to wash away. Everything that was exposed is there and present and still intact. So we're going to let that run for a couple more minutes and let it wash off completely, and then we'll continue the process from there. The wash is just about done now. We'll wait for the timer to go off. And once it's done, then we can open up the lid, and we can see that our polymer has, for the most part, washed clean where it was no longer, where it wasn't exposed, and where it was exposed is still present and visible. One thing I didn't mention about this green material is, and it's important, that it's not sticky when it's wet, but it's sticky when it's dry. So it's important that when you're done with the wash process, that you leave the lid open so that this stays dry and it stays sticky. If it rests in the water, it'll begin to deteriorate, and we'll have to replace it sooner than we have to. So moving over to the sink now, we're just going to give this a quick rinse under cold water just to get any excess polymer residue off prior to putting this in the drying tray to dry. Okay, so at this point, we'll shake off any excess water, and we'll move over to the drying tray where previously we had turned on the heater and the blower, and we'll just sit it on the tray there for a couple of minutes until all the water's dried off. So now that the polymer plate is dry, we can take it out of the drying area, and what we're going to do is put it back onto the exposing tray for another 3 minutes just to harden all of the polymer. At this point, we no longer need to heat the water. We can turn that off, turn the heater off and the blower. And again, we're just going to turn the lights on to expose. You can see the UV lights once again. I didn't put the polymer plate under the crean. I don't need a vacuum. It's just a simple matter of exposing it for another three and a half minutes. And once that's done, we can mount that to a wood board so we can put it on the press and print with it. All right, now that the 3 minutes have passed, we can turn the lights off and remove our polymer plate. This is now ready to be mounted with double-sided tape. We can see some examples here of how a polymer plate has been mounted to 3/4 inch MDF with double-sided tape. This is ready to go to the letterpress and be printed with our rubber-based inks. Okay.
So make sure you check out the rest of our videos located at the Tech Info site at design.yorku.ca/tech_info.